Christmas Eve, MTA fans, and welcome to the second annual Holiday Havoc event right here on the MTA YouTube channel. If you're new here, be sure to crush that subscribe button, turn on all notifications, and stay up to date with everything MTA has to offer. Tonight, we let go of 32 of the best diecast monster trucks, and they're going to tear it up for you fans in the last big event of the 2022 year, and they're getting ready to lay it all on the line for the Holiday Havoc Championship. The bad boys and girls of MTA are ready to go. The fans are packing the stands. Who walks away with the Holiday Havoc Championship? We're going to find out next, because round one action kicks off now, and we're going to see who's coming to the line first. Now, kicking off Holiday Havoc as round one gets started, we're going to see the long-awaited return of Gene Patterson and Snakebite. The Big Bad Ford at Cobra Creek, Colorado, now set to take on Jamie Hurd, another longtime MTA veteran now piloting the brand new Taurus machine, ready to go over here in the near lane. It's the Snake and the Bull. Who goes on to round two at Holiday Havoc? Green light goes down as we kick the show off. Down the straight stretch they go. Now they're pretty much even over the cars. Now, of course, Kevin low to the ground. Snakebite went high in the far lane, and it costed him right there. The Taurus machine and Jamie Hurd get the round one win. Now up next at Holiday Havoc, we've got the return of Caden Wilson in Jurassic Attack. He is now set to take on Savannah Zilogy and Little Miss Dangerous. Now both trucks have been battling it out on the Thunder Series all December season long. Caden Wilson trying to break out the round one curse here tonight at Holiday Havoc. Who goes on to round two competition? Both trucks stage now, and here goes the green light. Off the line they go now. Dangerous jumps them off the line. Jurassic Attack coming back now over the car. Jurassic Attack in trouble, turns it over, and the round one curse will bite him yet again as Little Miss Dangerous moves on into round two competition. Now the MTA track crew and officials are down there to roll him back over. Now you see a little bit of damage done to the body, but as they get him right side up, their crew's got a lot of R&D to do on that truck to get him back, hopefully for the January season of Thunder, and get that truck back and ready to go at 100% like it was when it debuted. Tough break for Jurassic Attack. Little Miss Dangerous does move on, however, as we move right along with the show. We're going to see Chantel Bailey return in the West Virginia Mountaineer, now set to take on Roland Cantwell in the Predator machine, powered by that big block Chevrolet. Roland Cantwell has done well for himself out here at these big events. He's got a longtime veteran over there in that far lane. Chantel ain't going to cut him any slack. Here's the green light now. Mountaineer and Predator off the line they go. Mountaineer pulling slightly. Predator trying to come back. Oh, doesn't have enough cars up. And Mountaineer will get the win. Chantel Bailey puts the Predator machine on the trailer as Mountaineer will move on into round two. Coming up to the line now is the return of Raylan Mullen. She's been duking it out on the December season of Thursday Night Thunder, ready to go in Medusa, now staged over here in the near lane. Coming back in the far lane is the return of Carson Wells, the Devastator Chevrolet. We haven't seen him out here in a long time. Glad to see him back. Chevrolet versus Ford in the matchup in round one. Who's going to round two? There's the green light now down the straight stretch. Devastator with the lead. Medusa playing catch up. It's close. All the way down to the shutdown area. Carson Wells and Devastator had a nice lead all the way down the straight stretch, but it was Medusa who put the foot to the floor there over the last set of cars. Here's our photo finish. Your winner is going to be Raylan Mullins and Medusa by inches over Devastator. What a great race that was, folks. But next up, John Kadiuk returns in the Bulldozer, now set to take on Cam Blank, who's been out here several times before at a Hagerstown, Maryland, the Iron Warrior machine over there in the far lane. Again, now taking on Bulldozer, stage in the near lane. John Kadiuk, always a threat out here on the MTA circuit. Green light goes down now. Iron Warrior with the lead. Bulldozer trying to come back. Gets crossed up and doesn't have enough. And Iron Warrior, Cam Blank, is your winner in round one competition. He puts the old bull on the trailer, ladies and gentlemen. Iron Warrior looking strong here tonight. Next up in round one is the current Thursday Night Thunder champion, Nathaniel Wiggins and Traxxas T-Max, now set to take on Justin Lamb returning in the Midnight Rider. Now a story with Nathaniel Wiggins. He defeated Walker Stevens, who was undefeated all December season long on Thunder. Again, he holds the checkered flag in that series. Here's the green light now. Can Wiggins hang on to it down the straight stretch? Up and over the cars. Lamb coming back in Midnight Rider. And the current Thunder champion may have struggled a little bit there in the shutdown area as Midnight Rider with a come from behind win. What an incredible race as we go down to our photo finish to confirm. Watch here in the near lane. It's going to be Midnight Rider by a 3/4 of a tire over T-Max. What a great race that was, folks. Next up in round one competition, Crustacean coming back after a long hiatus. Louis Givenese behind the wheel of the crustacean machine, the old monster lobster ready to go in the near lane. Over here in the far lane, however, Sawyer Ramsdale, Sudden Impact, who made a huge impression on the MTA circuit a couple of months ago. Sudden Impact out of Frackville, Pennsylvania, ready to go the big bad forward stage. Here's the green light down the stretch, two rookies throwing it down, up and over, no man's land, down they go across the finish line. I'm not sure who got the racing win here in round one. Crustacean versus Sudden Impact here as we go down now to our photo finish to confirm a winner. It's going to be Louis Givenese and the Crustacean Machine over here in the near lane. Next up in round one competition, we've got the return of Downtown Mitch Brown in Bigfoot. But that's a brand new Bigfoot, ladies and gentlemen. Bigfoot Firestone Wilderness ready to go in that far lane. He's debuting that truck right here tonight. But Joseph Nelson in Mindblower is looking to take away from the Bigfoot team over here in the near lane. Who's going on to round two? Ford versus Chevrolet. Now there's the green light down the straight track. Bigfoot with the lead. Looks like Mindblower coming back on him with some big time air up and over no man's land. And Joseph Nelson in Mindblower gets the round one win over the brand new Firestone Wilderness in the far lane. What an upset here in round one. But as we move on with the competition, Rudy Zilogy returning in the Rage Machine. Now sitting ready to take on the longtime MTA veteran, Wildman Ryan Johnson. Brodozer, he has staged now in the near lane. He wants to add another big championship to his list. Can he knock off Rage here in round one competition? Both trucks are staged at the line. Rage making a pretty big name for himself out here on MTA as we get set down with the green light down the straight track. Brodozer with the lead now. Rage coming back on him, and what a race it is. Both trucks getting out of shape. And look at Johnson. Parks it right there on that van stack in the shutdown area. What an incredible race by both drivers. They both got a little cattywampus out of no man's land, but they gathered it back up across the finish line. Here's a look at our photo finish. Your winner, Wildman Ryan Johnson and Brodozer. He will advance into round two. Next up in round one competition, we've got the long-awaited return of the Black Pearl Chevrolet driven by Sean Eichenberg. Now set to take on Ashley Obie in the brand new Scarlet Bandit Machine. It's making its debut right here tonight at Holiday Havoc, and she is looking to do well in a brand new truck. Who goes on to round two competition? Black Pearl, Scarlet Bandit, boat truck stage. Green light goes down now, even off the line. Scarlet Bandit pulling a strong lead over the cars, and what a race as Black Pearl was coming from behind there over the last set of cars. He was catching right on up with Scarlet Bandit. Let's go down to our MTA photo finish and try to confirm a winner. A lot of close, great racing here tonight. Here's your winner now, folks. It's going to be Ashley Obie and Scarlet Bandit by inches over the Black Pearl Machine. What an incredible race there. But as we move on with round one, it's the return of Charlie Stevens, the Built for Tough Blue Thunder, ready to go in that far lane. He's done pretty well for himself out there on the Thunder Circuit all December season long. However, over here in the near lane, Olivia Cantwell and the Nightmare Chevrolet looking to upset the big bad Ford over there. Green light goes down, Ford Chevrolet now. Blue Thunder pulling a lead. Nightmare trying to come back, doesn't have enough. And Blue Thunder, Charlie Stevens, putting the screws to the Nightmare Machine over there in that far lane. We're going to see the big bad Ford come back into round two competition. But next up, it's the return, the Outlaw, Joshua Wells in Carolina Crusher, making his long-awaited return to the MTA circuit. But he draws up an old rival over here, the Iceman, Jeffrey Skipper, back in the U.S. Air Force Afterburner. He is dialed in here tonight after qualifying. He stays now in the near lane. Who goes on to round two? Outlaw, Iceman, green light goes down. Now Crusher got him on the line. The Iceman trying to come back over the car, and I think he did it. Jeffrey Skipper pulled the trigger up and over no man's land. What an incredible race as the Iceman returns in the Air Force Machine. He will knock out Carolina Crusher in round one. Awesome racing there, but next up, it's the return of last year's Holiday Havoc champion, the Cowboy from Hell, Timothy Cantwell and Bounty Hunter, now set to take on Chase Moyse at a Killdevil Hills, North Carolina, the Gravedigger. Can last year's champion hold on here tonight? Another Ford and Chevrolet matchup. Digger and Bounty Hunter down the straight stretch. They got the Gravedigger with the lead. Bounty Hunter trying to come back, gets into the wall. And Chase Moyse and Gravedigger upsets last year's champion. The Bounty Hunter is on the trailer, unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, as Gravedigger moves on. What an upset there in round one. But next up, the kid that everyone's talking about, Walker Stevens, son of a digger out of Poplar Branch, North Carolina. He has been taking names out here on the Thunder Circuit all December season long. He just got beat this past Thursday. However, Ethan Wagner and Cyclops No slides to these big events. Here's the green light now. This one ought to be a barnburner. Sykes up to the lead over Stunt. Look at a comeback by Walker Stevens. And he turns it over in the shutdown area. What an incredible race, ladies and gentlemen. Wagner had a lead on him, but Stevens came back and put him on the trailer. And next up, ladies and gentlemen, it's the return of last month's champion at full throttle, Jimmy Ferguson, in the 1957 Chevy Bel Air Avenger, ready to go in that far lane. Now set to take on longtime veteran Aaron Church at Dragonoid, sporting a new body here tonight. He's looking to upset the full throttle champion here in round one. Who's moving on to round two? Here's the green light now. Avenger got him up the line. Dragonoid trying to come back, crosses up, turns it over, and Ferguson and Avenger get the round one win as Dragonoid goes over in the near lane. He had a hard crash, came off that wall, lands it on top of the car stack. Nonetheless, Avenger is your winner. Now the MTA track crew and officials are down there. The brand new body on Dragonoid destroyed here in round one competition as they roll him back over. They see a little bit of body damage done to the truck. Aaron Church and the crew are going to be thrashing. They will be back for 2023. I can guarantee you that. That's one great team and great crew behind the Dragonoid machine. But next up, a little bit of a storyline. This matchup was supposed to happen in the middle of the card. Rich Wagner and the Wild Hair Chevrolet team could not get the truck started. They finally got it fixed, and they had to move this race to the bottom of the bracket. So the winner of this race is going to face Cam Blank and Iron Warrior in round two. Aiden Johnson, Lumberjack in the near lane. Rich Wagner and Wild Hair in the far lane. Down the stretch and go. They're down even now. Up and over the car. And Aiden Johnson and Lumberjack puts the veteran on the trailer. And that, my friends, was the last ride for Rich Wagner and Wild Hair. As in 2023, he will be moving on to Team Gravedigger. Well, that was round one, ladies and gentlemen, as we get set for round two. And up first, Savannah. Zillagy returns, and Little Miss Dangerous now set to take on Jamie Hurd in that Taurus machine, the brand new truck, which made its debut last month. He did very well with it. He's looking strong here tonight. But what's Savannah got in that 1941 Willys over there in the far lane? Green light goes down now. She got him up the line. Taurus making a comeback over No Man's Land. Some sick air and a nice piece of driving by both drivers. And Taurus gets the win over Little Miss Dangerous here in round two competition. But next up in round one, Raylan Mullins returns in Medusa, as well as Chantel Bailey and the West Virginia Mountaineer. You can say we got a stage here of the Pink Ladies as Medusa closes out the 2022 season in her last ride in the Pink Medusa. She's got a brand new truck waiting for her. The veteran Chantel Bailey, Mountaineer here in the near lane, knows how to get the job done. It's a battle of the Ford up and down the straight stretch. They go, Mountaineer pulling a slight lead. Medusa's coming from behind, but Mountaineer gets the round two win over Medusa there in that far lane. So we'll see Chantel Bailey back in the Mountaineer Ford in round three competition. Next up in round two, it's the return of Aiden Johnson and Lumberjack, who just knocked off the Wild Hair machine. As we said in that competition, that bracket was moved to the latter half of the show just to get Wild Hair fixed. And now Aiden Johnson gets the matchup against Cam Blank in Iron Warrior out of Hagerstown, Maryland. Stage now in the near lane. Who's going on to round three? Green light goes down now. Johnson got a lead on him. Looks like Blank trying to come back in the Warrior and doesn't have enough. And Lumberjack gets the round two win over the Iron Warrior machine as Lumberjack will advance on into round three competition. Next up in round two, we've got the return of the Monster Lobster Crustacean. Louis Jimenez ready to go here to take on the veteran Justin Lamb, Midnight Rider, who looked strong in round one. He is now staged over here in the near lane. Midnight Rider, always a crowd favorite out here on the MTA circuit. Boat truck staged up at the line. Round three on the line. Green light goes down now. Who's going on to the round three competition? Over No Man's Land now. Crustacean pulls out the win. And Midnight Rider was trying to come back on him, just didn't have enough. Crustacean gets the round two win over Midnight Rider. But next up in round two, we've got the return of Joseph Nelson and Mindblower. We just watched him knock off longtime veteran Mitch Brown and Bigfoot, but now he draws up another veteran with a lot of credentials to his name. Wildman Ryan Johnson and Protos are ready to go in the far lane. Who's going on to round three competition? Nelson's got his hands full. Here's the green light now down the straight stretch. They're dead even. Nelson's got a lead on. Protos can't come back. And Joseph Nelson puts another veteran on the trailer. The kid is dialed in here tonight in the Mind Blower machine. What a great race there for the kid in the Astro van. Next up, Charlie Stevens in the Built for Tough Blue Thunder ready to go to take on the brand new Scarlet Bandit machine. Ashley Obie over there in the far lane. Now, Charlie Stevens in Blue Thunder, he's been running strong all December season long on Thunder. But right now, he's got to knock off the brand new Scarlet Bandit in the far lane. Here we go now as we go green down the straight track. Bandit's got a lead on a Blue Thunder's trying to come back. Bandit's in trouble, turns it over. And Blue Thunder will get the round two win over Scarlet Bandit. What an incredible race there as she goes end over end over the last set of cars. Going back now to the MTA replay. Watch right here. Bandit got him off the line. Blue Thunder starting to come back down the straight stretch, catching up to her. They are pretty much even here, up and over no man's land. Look how out of shape Blue Thunder is, but look at Scarlet Bandit toting it over in the far lane. What an incredible matchup nonetheless. Blue Thunder is your winner. But next up, the black and green, well, I should say chrome and green wrecking machine here tonight. Chase Moyse in the Gravedigger, ready to go now against Jeffrey Skipper, returning in the U.S. Air Force Afterburner. The Iceman ready to go here in the near lane to take out the Gravedigger here in round two. Can he do it? We're going to find out. Here's a green light now. Gravedigger and Afterburner down the stretch. Skipper's got a lead on him. He's out of shape. Turns the truck over. Gravedigger loses the body. What an incredible matchup here in round two. Skipper pulling out what Scarlet Bandit just did in the other lane. Chase Moyse and the Gravedigger losing the body. What an incredible matchup here. Both of them wanted it. They were hungry here tonight for the Holiday Havoc Championship. I don't know who got the win. I do believe it was Jeffrey Skipper as we look at the MTA replay. Look how squirrely he is coming down the straight stretch. He gets all out of shape right here, up and over no man's land. A hard hit on the front axle. Flips it end over end. Chase Moyse and the Gravedigger almost crossed up lanes. He gets himself back in the right direction, but nonetheless, Jeffrey Skipper and Afterburner is your winner. But now to close out round two competition, Walker Stevens and Son of a Digger, the 2022 Redemption Champion, now set to take on Jimmy Ferguson and Avenger, the 2022 Full Throttle Champion. These two are going to be throwing it down to close out round two competition. Son of a Digger and Avenger. Green light goes down now. Digger's got a lead on him. Avenger's trying to come back and doesn't have enough. And Walker Stevens will turn it over again for the second time tonight, trying to shut down that truck. Nonetheless, Son of a Digger moves on into round three competition. But folks, before we get to round three, we want to take you down to the MTA pits. Check this out, ladies and gentlemen, for 2023, Wildman Ryan Johnson will be debuting the brand new Super Trucker. Alongside him, Chantel Bailey debuting a brand new West Virginia Mountaineer. But the big storyline here tonight at Holiday Havoc, Jeffrey Skipper and the crew are down there thrashing. They did a lot of damage to the front end of that truck on that hard pogo there in round two. The crew's trying to get him back and ready to go for round three. Hopefully they can make the call here at Holiday Havoc. But now we've got to get round three up and going. The clock is ticking. And first up, Chantel Bailey returns in the West Virginia Mountaineer to take on that wicked fast Taurus machine piloted by Jamie Hurd here tonight. He's been looking strong all night long, but so has Chantel Bailey in the West Virginia Mountaineer Ford over there in the far lane. This one's going to semis. Here's the green light now down the straight stretch. They're dead even now to the first jump over the car. Now and Taurus gets the win. Bailey's upside down. West Virginia Mountaineer goes over, and the Taurus machine will move on in the semifinal competition. What a great matchup there. Let's go down and check out the replay. They were pretty much even off the start here. Maybe a slight lead to Taurus down the straight stretch. Bailey knows she's starting to fall a little bit behind. Tries to gather it up, but gets crossed up in no man's land. Tried to save it on two wheels and just dumped it on its lid. Taurus is the winner and moves on to semifinal competition. But now the MTA track crew and officials are down there to roll Mountaineer back over. And hey, what a way to debut a new truck next year. You total out the old one here at the end of 2022. So we'll see her back next year in a brand new Mountaineer truck. Can't wait for that. But next up, Aiden Johnson returns in Lumberjack. Now set to take on Louis Givinese in the Monster Lobster Crush Station. He's been dialed in here tonight over there in the far lane. What's Lumberjack got for him? Aiden Johnson again staged here in the near lane at Holiday Havoc. Who's going on to semis? Boat truck stage now at the line as we get set to go green. Off the line they go. Lumberjack with a big time lead. Crush Station was sleeping. Turns the truck over there across the finish line. But Lumberjack and Aiden Johnson is your round three winner. He will advance on to semifinal competition. And now the MTA track crew and officials are down there with the Monster Lobster. Louis Givinese got a little crossed up over that last stack of cars. He couldn't gather it up and turn the truck over. The fans are going nuts. And there you see the rear end has completely came out from underneath that truck. He's got a lot of thrashing to do with his crew to make it back for 2023. No doubt in my mind they'll get it done, but round three continues because Joseph Nelson returns in Mindblower. Now set to take take on Charlie Stevens. The Built For Tough Blue Thunder ready to go here in the near lane, but the kid in that far lane in Mind Blower, he's been on fire all night long, knocked off two veterans. What's he got for Blue Thunder? Green light goes down now. Mind Blower's got him off the line. Blue Thunder coming back over the car now. And what a close race it was. Joseph Nelson turning it over in the far lane. Blue Thunder backs it up off the cars there. That was way too close to call, but we're getting word. Blue Thunder is your winner. Next up, as we close out round three, Walker Stevens and Son of a Digger on another rail here tonight at Holiday Havoc. Over here in the near lane, the Iceman, Jeffrey Skipper. We saw him turn the truck over in round two competition. A hard hit on the front of that truck, but the crew's got him back. Son of a Digger, Afterburner, green light goes down now off the line. They're pretty much even to the first stack of the cars now. And it's close. Skipper may have just pulled out the upset. The Iceman's never raced Walker Stevens. He got his first crack at him here tonight at Holiday Havoc, and it was a barn burner, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go down to our photo finish and try to see who won right here at the finish line. Walker Stevens and Son of a Digger by a tire length over the Afterburner. What an incredible matchup that was, but now we started with 32. We are now down to four trucks. It's semifinal time, and up first, Aiden Johnson returns in Lumberjack to take on Jamie Hurd in the Taurus Machine, his brand new truck. He's been running well with it at the last couple events. He's ready to go and dialed in at Holiday Havoc, but so is Aiden Johnson, Lumberjack in the far lane. Who's going to the finals, folks? Green light goes down now off the line. They're pretty much even down the straight stretch, up and over the cars at Taurus. Lumberjack goes over, but Taurus and Jamie Hurd get the win in semifinals. He puts the big bad bull in the finals here at Holiday Havoc. Lumberjack upside down there in the far lane. But who does Taurus meet in the final round? It's the father-son matchup yet again. They've met a couple of times on Thunder, and Walker Stevens and Son of a Digger has upset his proud papa on numerous occasions. It's tonight, Blue Thunder's night, as Charlie Stevens and the Built For Tough Blue Thunder try to put the screws to Son of a Digger. This one's for bragging rights, ladies and gentlemen. Son of a Digger in the far lane, Blue Thunder in the near lane. Who's going to the final? Green light goes down off the line. Son of a Digger going to lead. Blue Thunder's trying to come back out of shape. It's close, but Walker Stevens and Son of a Digger will upset his proud papa yet again. A great matchup nonetheless, but Son of a Digger is your winner here at Holiday Havoc, and that means he advances on to the finals. And hey, that's what we all come here to see. It's final time at the second annual Holiday Havoc. Walker Stevens and Son of a Digger will take on Jamie Hurd in the brand new Taurus Machine. These two trucks have been wicked fast all night long. Jamie Hurd trying to get a big event championship here on the MTA circuit. Walker Stevens got the 2022 Redemption Championship. Son of a Digger is always a force out here. But that brand new Taurus Machine and Jamie Hurd are dialed in and set up tonight on the track. Who takes home the Holiday Havoc Championship? Son of a Digger, Taurus. It's showtime, ladies and gentlemen. There's the green light down the straight track. Son of a Digger's got a lead. Taurus coming back on him over the car. It's close. And Jamie Hurd with a save down there in the shutdown area. What a close race all the way down to the finish line. Both drivers letting it all hang out, trying to pick up the big win. We're not too sure who did get the win just yet. We're going down now to our MTA replay. Let's take another look at it right here off the line. Son of a Digger caught the green light a little bit quicker, but Taurus made up the ground. Down the straight stretch they go. Watch them up and over no man's land. They're flying high to the finish line, and right there, Taurus and Jamie Hurd will knock off Son of a Digger in the final round here at Holiday Havoc. Jamie Hurd with an incredible save trying to shut the truck down. What a matchup it was for the finals. But ladies and gentlemen, your 2022 Holiday Havoc champion, congratulations to Jamie Hurd and Taurus. What a great night of racing here on the MTA YouTube channel to close out the 2022 year, our last big event, Holiday Havoc. We all hope you had a great time here on the MTA YouTube channel. We'll be back next year, better than ever for 2023. It's not over yet, though. Check out Midwest Madness YouTube channel tomorrow night for Winter Wipeout. 32 of the best trucks and drivers are throwing it down for the Winter Wipeout Championship. Thank you, everyone, for coming out and watching Holiday Havoc. We all hope you had a great time. Thank you guys for supporting this YouTube channel for as long as you have. We'll catch you guys next year for 2023. Be sure, if you haven't already, crush that subscribe button, and I'll catch you down the road. See you next year.